Praise God. My name is Pastor Michael Bryan of Restored Ministries International right here in Rio Rancho. And I want to thank you for joining in on the broadcast. And the Word of God says in Joel chapter 2, verse 25, "And I will restore unto you all the years that the locust, caterpillar, cankerworm, and palmer worm have eaten away." Now be ready to be refreshed, restored, and activated in your purpose. Be blessed. Praise God, praise God. I want to thank everyone for joining us for the Restored Ministries International broadcast and me, Pastor Michael Bryant. Today, we're going to be unlocking some windows of heaven today. Amen. The Bible says that He would open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, pour you out an empowerment to prosper and be successful, that you would not have room enough to receive it. So today, I believe if we would get the understanding of God, get the seed of the Word, and begin to activate this Word, then there will be nothing keeping the blessing from being poured out upon our lives. So let's just lift up your hands. Father, we thank you right now that according to your Word, Father, you said all things work together for good for those who love God and for those who are called according to your purpose. Father, right now, we thank you, Lord God, and we give the Holy Spirit free reign to heal, save, move, and deliver as you see fit. Father, we just speak right now by faith that you are going to draw the ones that need to hear your Word, this particular message that is looking for this answer in their lives right now. Now, devil, we serve you. Notice that the blood of Jesus is against you and no weapon formed against them, no weapon formed against the broadcast or this ministry or TV station shall ever prosper. And Father, right now, we're going to be careful to give you all the glory, all the honor and praise. Now, Father, we thank you, Lord God, that you said that for as many as received you, the Word, you gave them the power to become your sons. And in Jesus' name, we just say less of us, more of you, none of us, all of you. Think through my mind and speak through my vocal cords that none of your Word would fall to the ground. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen. Now listen, we have entered in to the season and the time of the Feast of Tabernacles or the Feast of Harvest. It's also called the Feast of Ingathering. And we're going to share a few things today because I want you to understand that when the Bible says with all you're getting, get understanding, we need to make sure that we are understanding the promises of God, which is the Old Testament, connected to the fulfillment of those promises, which is the New Testament. So let's go to the Word of God and let's just open up some things and let's see how God wants us to embrace and receive His blessing. Go to Hosea chapter 4, starting at verse 6. Come on now. And it says, "My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Because you have rejected knowledge, I have also rejected you as my priests. Because you have ignored the law or the word of your God, I will also ignore your children." Now, let's just back up here really quick. It says, "My people are destroyed." He's not talking about the sinner because the Bible says that the wages of sin is death. So he's not talking about the ones who don't have a relationship with him. He's not talking about the ones who don't have any experience or knowledge of the word. He's talking to the ones who should know better. Now, glory, now what you got to understand is when discipline happened in my household, it always began with the phrase, "What did I tell you to do?" Now, so if we're going to understand is that God loves us and He treats us as a father to children. So when He gives us instruction, when He gives us understanding, His purpose is not to destroy us. His purpose is not to say, "Oh, the only thing you can't do this, you can't do this, you can't do this, you can't do this," and never tell us what we can do. See, God says, Jesus said it like this, "I came that you might possess life, and that you might possess it beyond measure. But how can we possess the life of God, the Zoe, the absolute fullness of God, and not get an understanding of what he said of how to live? Oh, come on now, we're going somewhere. He says, so my people, the ones who should know, are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Now, this word knowledge right here is a Hebrew word that means understanding. So, this is going to be key today. In order for you to reap your harvest, we always want to talk about the hundredfold, 60-fold, and 30-fold, where you're going to understand that when we come into his presence at the appointed time of God, we have automatic access to the hundredfold. And let's just prove this by the word. Go to Psalms chapter 102. Come on, stay with me. Now listen, if you need prayer, if you need more understanding, listen, go to the phone. Call the number on your screen, 505-220-4962. Someone will pray with you. Someone will help you. If you need to contact by email, go to the www.restoredministriesint.org. That's our website. We have more teachings on the feast. We have contact information that you can email us, and we'll correspond and help you get understanding. But listen, my job as a prophet and pastor of God is to teach you what he said with understanding and clarity so you can go live it. Psalms 102, look at verse 12 and 13. And he says, but you, O Lord, shall endure forever. And your renown endures throughout all generations. You shall arise and have mercy upon Zion for the time to show favor to her. Yea, the set time or the appointed time has or is come, depending on what translation that you're reading from. I'm reading from the NIV, but the King James Version says, the set time is come, present tense. So now what you got to understand is, since we are in the Feast of Tabernacles or the Feast of Ingathering, it's also called the Feast of Harvest, this is a present tense, a present time that God has come to empower you, to bless you, to multiply you. Now, this phrase set time means appointed time. It is a Hebrew word that means appointed time, appointed meeting, and appointed place. So God is the one that sets this time in the earth. Now, I'm going to show you that, first of all, this is God's time. I'm also going to show you that the feast of the Lord are feasts of the Lord and not just Jewish feasts. Because I know that there's a misunderstanding or a misconception in the body of Christ that, yeah, we're all saved by grace, so we ain't got to do anything else that happens in the Old Testament. But just because we're saved by grace, it doesn't mean that we don't have to do what he said in the Ten Commandments. Come on, stay with me now. See, we can't be selective on the word that we want to obey and fulfill. Because he says, man doesn't live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. And what you have to make a decision is, do I believe that this is the word of God? If this is the word of God that was written down by inspiration of man through the Holy Ghost, then I need to follow the word because it teaches me how to live a successful, God-like life here on earth. See, we can have heaven on earth if we follow his instructions. Amen? Okay. So, we are in a set time of God. Someone shout set time. So God sets the time, he sets the place, and he sets the meeting. So let's go and let's get some understanding of how it was established. Go to Exodus chapter 3. Come on now. Exodus chapter 3. I'm going to try to do this as quickly as possible, but I must give you understanding so you know why God says come into his presence at this time. Exodus chapter 3, look at verse 2. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto Moses from a burning bush. And Moses saw that the bush was on fire, but it did not burn up. So Moses said, I will go and see this strange sight, why the bush is not burned up. And when the Lord, so we know it's not just an angel, but it's the Lord. Let me prove it. The Lord saw that he had gone to look, and God called him from within the bush. He didn't say the angel. He said God. Elohim was the actual Hebrew word here. Elohim, the creator, called him from the bush, saying, Moses, Moses. And Moses said, here I am. He says, do not come any closer. God said, take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. Oh, glory. So just an angel will not cause the ground around you to become holy. We understand that when God shows up, everything where he is becomes holy. Look at what he says. Then God said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And at this, Moses hid his face. And the Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I have heard them crying because of their slave drivers, and I am concerned about their suffering. So I have come down to deliver and rescue them from the hands of the Egyptians and to bring them out unto a land, into a good and spacious land. Oh, I love this NIV version right here. A land flowing with milk and honey. Now, presently, it's the home of the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. But, so now, go, and I am sending you to Pharaoh to bring them out. See, what you got to understand is, when God said in the Bible, the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just, you have to understand that these seven descendants of Canaan were the people that God is saying, I'm letting them hold on to your stuff until you get there. Come on, somebody. And he didn't give it to an angel. He didn't give it to Gabriel, a messenger. He didn't give it to Michael, the archangel, the fighter. He said, I am come down personally to deliver you from the hands of your oppressors and take you out of Egypt, the land of not enough, into your inheritance, which is always more than enough. Come on, somebody. So, let's break this down even more. Now, listen, understand. This is where we have to understand, this is the beginning where the Lord begins to declare, I'm going to start giving you certain times in the year that I will come down personally and visit with you and do signs, wonders, and miracles that will take you through the next upcoming year. Let me just show you really quick, amen? Glory. Come on. Are you getting something? Listen, if you're getting something already, listen, go to the website, www.restoredministriesint.org. I've got more teachings on the feast. The Lord has really blessed us to give us the word and the revelation to give people understanding of why we need, even the ones who are believers and not from what we would normally call Jewish descent, we are supposed to participate in God's visitation. And I'm going to show you why. Go to Exodus chapter 23. And for time's sake, we're going to look at we're going to start at verse 2. Now, what you got to understand is this phrase, Feast of Tabernacle, it's a celebration of the harvest or of the ingathering. And when you understand, when I show this to you, you understand that the Israelites at this time, they were either herders or they were all farmers because they grew their food. So sometimes you have to understand that when God is doing something in your life, he used a physical means to give you a spiritual understanding. Amen. Look at verse, for time's sake, look at verse 14. It says, three times a year you are to celebrate a feast unto me. Or he also said in the King James, three times in the year, you are supposed to come into my presence and celebrate the feast of the Lord. And he says, celebrate the feast of unleavened bread, glory, for 7 days. Do this at the appointed time in the month of Abib, for this is the month that you came out of Egypt. So when they killed the sheep and they put the blood on the doorpost, And then God said, when I send my death angel, when he sees the blood, oh, come on, somebody. It's just like right now when Jesus shed his blood. And because when we get saved, he covers us with his blood. The death angel has no power. Oh, come on, somebody. He said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Come on, somebody. Now, he says, now look, no one is to appear before me empty-handed. Then he says, also celebrate the feast of first fruit or the feast of Pentecost. Then he says, celebrate the feast of ingathering or the feast of tabernacle at the end of the year. So what you got to understand is this right here is a double portion time of God, because we come into his presence at the feast of tabernacle to praise God for what he's done. And then we're going to praise God in advance for what he's going to do. Oh, come on, somebody. So you're thanking him that he gave you a crop. You're thanking him that he kept you healthy. You're thanking him because he got your unsaved loved one saved. So you're thanking God for what he's done, but then you're thanking God in advance for what he's going to do in your life. We're walking in the area of faith. This is not the area of works or the law, as we have sometimes taken out of context. When we understand that when we do these things by faith, we are doing this to please God, not because of a tradition, not because of a religious act. We want to make sure that God has the opportunity to pour in our lives. But he says then in verse 16, 17, celebrate the feast of ingathering at the end of the year when you gather in your crops from the field. Three times in a year shall all men or mankind appear before the sovereign Lord. Shall all mankind appear before the Lord. So God comes down. He says, I am come down at these times to deliver you. Now listen, here's the key. There are five areas when we come into God's presence at these Moedims, these appointed times, that God says, in these five areas, I'm going to take care of you. Verse 20, he says, behold, I am sending an angel ahead of you to guard you along the way, to bring you to the place that I have prepared. Pay attention to him and listen to what he says. Do not rebel against him, because he will not forgive your rebellion, since my name, Yahshua, Jehovah, is in him. If you listen carefully to what he says to do and all that I will tell you, I will be an enemy to your enemies. Number one, I will be an adversary to your adversaries. Number two, and then I will bring you before your enemies, the Canaanites, the Perizzites, the Jebusites, the Hivites, and the Hittites, and I will wipe them out before you. Glory, hit to the ball. Glory, shit to the ball. Glory, I will be a blessing to your food and water, and I will take away sickness from the midst of you, and none of you will go barren. Do you understand what God is saying? When we come into his presence, it's not only a time of rest, because when you do the studies, these times of the feast are what we call Shabbats or Sabbaths, okay, where we do no work. No work. It's a time of rest. It's a time for us to come into his presence and enjoy the presence of God, because the Bible says where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Amen and amen. So let's go here. Glory, glory, glory. Oh, hey, glory. Ah, my goodness. There's so much here that I want to give to you. But listen, let's go right here. We're going to go to 1 Corinthians chapter 5. So that way we just ain't going to see Old Testament. We're going to see New Testament. Amen. So that way you can just say, oh, but I'm a New Testament Christian. Amen. Go to 1 Corinthians chapter 5. Amen. Now, this is the brother Paul, and we're going to start at verse 4. He said, when you are assembled in the name of the Lord Jesus, and I am with you in spirit, and in the power of the Lord Jesus is present, let's go ahead and go to verse 7. I'm sorry. He says, get rid of the old leaven that you may be a new batch without leaven as you really are. For Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us keep the feast not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the bread without leaven, the bread of sincerity and truth. When you understand that in the Old Testament, they physically got all the leaven out of the house because God said that the leaven represented sin. So they were supposed to physically do a physical model of getting sin out of the house. Because Jesus came and died on the cross, now we can do the feast with an understanding that we spiritually get the sin out of this body, this house, because we are the body. We are the body. We are the temple of the Holy Ghost. So we need to get the old leaven out. He says, old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. One more scripture here. 1 Corinthians, go over to chapter 16. So much. Look at verse 6. Perhaps I will stay with you a while or even spend the winter so that you can help me on my journey wherever I go. I do not want to see you now and make only a passing visit. I hope to spend some time with you if the Lord permits. But I will stay on at Ephesus until the Feast of Pentecost, because a great door of an effectual door has been opened unto me, and there are so many adversaries that oppose me. So these times of the feast are doors of opportunity of God pouring in our lives. Glory. So let's do this. Let's pray. Because I want you to understand that when we come into His presence three times in the year, Feast of Passover, Feast of Pentecost, Feast of Tabernacles, God comes down to not only deliver us, He seals the book of blessing, which shows and tells Him what He's going to pour in your life for the next upcoming year. And He gives us opportunity to repent of any sins of omission and commission that we might have done knowingly or unknowingly in the past year, so we can get it straight. Because the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all His righteousness, then all these things shall be added unto you. How can God add things unto us if we're not in proper standing with Him? And I know what you're saying. God's not concerned about things in our life, but that's not the truth. Really quick, before we have to go to a quick break, go to Luke chapter 19. Look at verse 41. Amen. And it says, and He approached Jerusalem, and He saw the city, and He wept over it. And He says, if you, even you, had only known on this day, oh, glory, what would bring your peace, glory, or the things that belong to your peace, but now have been hidden from your eyes. Glory. These days will come unto you that your enemies will encamp around you. Verse 44, they will dash you to the ground, you and your children within your walls. They will not leave one stone on another, because you did not recognize the time of God's visitation unto you. This is the time of God's visitation in your life. Receive the seed of the word that He can pour out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive. We'll be right back. Praise God, praise God. I want to thank you for joining us for the Restored Ministries International broadcast and me, Pastor Michael Bryan. But listen, we're going to take a moment to pray and we're going to activate this blessing, this time and season in your life. And then we're also going to give you an opportunity to be able to go to the website. The website address is on your screen, www.restoredministriesint.org, and become a partner. Look at the videos, get more of the teaching, and become a sponsor and partner of this ministry so we can keep this word, this teaching of the gospel that's been a blessing to you, I believe, going out into all the world. Father, right now, your word says that we confess with our mouths and believe in our heart that Jesus Christ died on the cross, was buried, and rose again on the third day, then we can be saved. Father, right now, cleanse us from all our sins. We repent of every sin of omission and commission, knowingly and unknowingly done in this body. Father, forgive us because we knew not what we were doing. Now, Father, pour into our heart the Holy Spirit. Activate the word, the seed of the word in our heart that we might not sin against you. And Father, give us the wisdom and understanding that we can always stay in right standing with you and please you, not just by trying to be good, but following the plan of God for our life. Now, devil, we serve you. Notice that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And from this time forward, we shall be sons and daughters of the God Most High. I want to thank you once again for joining us for the broadcast. Don't miss next week's broadcast, but remember, you are going to be restored in Jesus' name.